and I can move to the next track and the fader will update itself. Also, if I want, for example, to solo this track and solo this. So hello, in this video I'm going to show you my long-awaited motorized fader Faderport clone DIY MIDI controller called Faduino. I've been working on this controller for probably more than a year, or at least some several months. I've already done some iterations in the PCB, in the enclosure, and I've been coding a lot. And I finally got into a version that I liked a lot and I believe you will like too. So what this controller is all about? First, it has a motorized fader, several silicone buttons with LEDs, and a rotary encoder. And one of the greatest things about this controller is that it works with the Maquis protocol, so it will work natively in any DAW, including Pro Tools. So why using a controller like that? Because you have the motorized fader, when you change the tracks in your DAW, the controller understands the new position of the fader in the DAW, and the motor moves the fader to the appropriate position. So with one fader, you can map lots of faders in the DAW, and when you change tracks, you know that it won't skip the values because the physical position of your fader didn't change. Something that's impossible with regular faders and rotary potentiometers. Also, you have some similar capabilities with the rotary encoder. Plus, you have lots of buttons that can control other things, such as solo, mute, arm, record, stop, among other things in your DAW. And because it's open source, you can edit the code, you can add functionalities, and do the way you want. And this project wouldn't be possible, or it would be really harder to do, if it was not for JLC PCB. JLC PCB is a company that manufactures really high-quality printed circuit boards, or PCBs, and they provided me with free PCBs for this project. So you can see here, this is the Faduino PCB. It's super beautiful, super well finished, and it came already with the SMD components soldered, so they have this service too. I really recommend them. You can start doing your PCBs for as low as $2. I was already using their services before they approached me, telling that they wanted to do a partnership, so that's the best partnership ever. Link here below. So before we can see the controller in action, let's see how it was made. Okay, so now that we have our Faduino assembled, or almost assembled, we need to connect it to the computer. And one really important thing is that it needs a 9 volts power supply. So I'm going to connect the power supply here. And also the USB micro. Those USB ports are a little fragile, so be careful to not damage the Arduino. Now you need to come to the Faduino GitHub repository, download the files here. Soon there will be more files such as schematics, KiCad files, etc. Then come to the folder you downloaded, come to this folder and open the first file called Faduino. You will need to add a bunch of libraries, and I'll leave a full tutorial inside my course, The Making Music with Arduino. Also there how to configure the controller and lots of other things. So if you need a detailed tutorial to build the controller, please check my course, The Making Music with Arduino. Okay, I'm gonna choose here my USB port and upload the code. You could see that the fader moved up and down. It needs to happen because that's how the fader is configured, its maximum and minimum values. And now let's open the DAW. I'm going to use Ableton Live. And one thing important to keep in mind, this is a DIY controller. I designed and built everything myself, from the enclosure, the PCB, I programmed everything. So don't expect that we'll be as good or have all the functionalities of a fader port, but I believe I covered most of the things you need when doing music production. And to be honest, I'm quite happy with it. The Faduino works with the MACI protocol or MCU, so it will work natively in any DAW, including Logic Pro or Pro Tools. However, I only tested with Ableton. And to use it with Ableton, you come here to Preferences, MIDI, and Control Surface, and choose MACI Control. And here in Input and Output, choose Faduino. That's all you need to do. So if I move here my fader, you can see that the fader moves in the DAW. And if I move here, it moves the fader in the controller. But okay, it can do way more than that, so let's add a bunch of tracks here. Just like any MACI controller, it works in banks of 8 tracks. So I'm going to color those tracks just to make sure we know where we are. So, okay, I am in track 1, so I can move the fader here. And now we have a bunch of buttons and a rotary encoder that can do a lot of things. For example, in this row, I can press this button for solo, and you can see that when a button is active, the color will be brighter. So solo, I can mute, I can arm, and this is a shift button that we're gonna take a look later. And those buttons here, I can, in this button, move to another track. So here, for example, and I can move to the next track and the fader will update itself. Also, if I want, for example, to solo this track and solo this, you will see that also the LED will update itself to whatever you have in the DAW. So here I can unmute, or here I can mute, and this track I can arm. Let's arm this track here. So you can see that also those two buttons here, they are momentary, so they lit up when you press, just for you to see that the press work and just looks nice. And all the tracks get updated here in the controller when it gets a MIDI message from the DAW. So you don't need to map anything. Another cool thing, like we have this shift button. So if I press shift and solo, I unsolo all the tracks. And if I press shift and I press this, I unmute all the tracks. And the same thing, if I press shift and arm, I unarm all the tracks. And these other two buttons here, I can change to the next bank. So if I press this, now I am in track 9. So I can move my faders here. So now the controller is only working in this next bank. So for example, if I solo this and solo this, if I press unmute or unsolo, it will only work in these 8 tracks. So you need to pay attention to that. So now if you want to control those first 8 tracks, you come back here and you're ready to control it. Then we have these four buttons here that do some general things in the DAW. And depending on the DAW, they will do different things. So it's nice if you can change this in the code so you can know which message to change in order to control whatever you want in the DAW. So that's the magic about being open source. You can change it. And again, I'm going to leave a full tutorial on how to change those things, how to have full control of the controller so you can edit for your needs. And the next four buttons, here I have a general just turns on the loop on and off. It could be any other thing. Here is play. Here is a stop. Here is record. So it's recording, so you can see that record and play is on, and I can stop and everything comes back to the beginning. Okay, so now what about the encoder and those buttons? So each of those buttons here in the top will change the functionality of the encoder. I don't have 8 functionalities yet. I intend to improve, but I already have 3. So the first 3 will make the encoder do different things. So in the first bank, I can use it for pan. So I can change the track and change the pan of each track. And one nice thing is that once I press the encoder, it has a click. The V-pot or the knob in the DAW comes back to the middle, which is pretty nice. When you are in this second bank here or in the second mode, you can see that if you move the knob here, it changes the tracks, but it's not really what it's intended for. For example, if we come here, we can move we can move the beats here, can go to any place. Okay? So in the third one, this one is really nice, is that you can use the knob here to move between tracks. So you can move between tracks faster. So now let's just put some stems here so we can actually listen with music. Those are free stems I downloaded. I don't even know what they are right now. Okay, so let's see what we can do here. So see that I am in track 8, so if I want to go to the 9th, I actually need to go to the next bank, okay? So see how well this is working and how much faster this can make your workflow. So yeah, I introduce you officially to the Faduino. So what did you think? It was probably the hardest or the second hardest controller I ever made, but I am really happy with the result. It was really hard to make, mostly because of the motorized fader. To make a motorized fader work is tricky. To make a motorized fader work well
is really tricky. Plus, it uses the Maquis protocol, which is a proprietary protocol. So I really had to dig on the internet to know which kinds of messages to send to control the different types of parameters in the DAW. Also, I had to design from scratch a PCB with digital LEDs, voltage dividers to work with the power supply, etc. So if you want to show your support, subscribe and like this video. So if you want to build something like this, I'll leave a full tutorial in my Making Music with Arduino course, link here below. Also, if you want to design your PCBs, I have the KiCad course, and if you want to learn how to code, I have my Arduino programming course. You can buy the three with a special discount in my Nerd Musician Pro course bundle. And if you want to buy the parts or a kit, I also leave the link here below. Maybe when you see the video, the kits will not be available yet, but you can join a waiting list and I'll let you know as soon as I have. So let me know what you thought about this controller and what kind of project should I do next. Maybe 8 motorized faders? We'll see. See you in the next one. Ciao.